out. Monsters everywhere. I need to grab my share and leave. I thought I was the only one with a sound mind here. Sure, I don't need to introduce myself. Note these golden wings. Yes, you guessed it. You don't know who I am. Preposterous! Everyone in Kraat has heard of me. Do you live under a rock? I'm Alidoro the Hound, treasure hunter extraordinaire. Yes, yes, it's a nickname. I ditched my real name in the past. I'm looking for other survivors of this disaster, but it's been a lonely search, and there's danger around every corner. Do you know of a place where I can take refuge? Preferably someplace clean and comfortable, you know, civilized. Hotel Kraat, of course, a haven for all, and it's still safe and sound, you say? I have a lot of searching ahead of me, so why don't I lighten my load? Consider this an act of charity. A thank you gift. Take it. Since you're so helpful, I'll give you a peek at my collection. Show me what you're worthy of. As a descendant of aristocrats, the very best families, I have a duty to the common people. I live my life fulfilling that duty. And part of that duty is ensuring these items are returned to their rightful owners. What I'm showing you is just a portion of the collection. If you come to the refuge, we'll be able to continue our confabulation. Until then, remember this hound when golden wings shine.
Oh, thank you. Just seeing the Archbishop's holy mark renews my spirit. It's a reminder of the quiet power of faith. I'll remember this forever, Stalker. It's a reminder of the quiet power.
I'll use my power to help you.
Thank you. I want to go back to the old Krat. The old me. Before the greed overtook me.
Name happened here. Oh, I haven't a clue myself. There's gotta be someone at the hotel who knows something. Once, Krat was just a small town on the coast of little importance. Before Elysian Boulevard was built, this place literally was all there was of Krat. But when some in the city prospered, they left the old town behind. Through isolation and neglect, Krat's first incarnation became nothing but dangerous alleys and desperate slums. On the bright side, I guess, the whole city of Krat's pretty much like that now. The old town caught up with the new. It's true what they say. A receding tide sinks all boats.
I've been investigating the puppet frenzy, and it looks like I need your help. First, let me show you a little something I've been working on. I call it the Ergo Wavelength Decoder. The name lacks a certain flair, but I assure you it works. If my suspicions are correct, something in the puppet's very ergo is causing their aggression. My decoder can find malicious signals within the waves, but I cannot possibly get close enough to gather the ergo wave records myself. You, on the other hand, would you? Could you? I refuse to believe the King of Puppets is truly behind this puppet rampage. It's too simple, but also a bit too much even for him. No. I suspect the ergo itself is corrupted, or at least compromised. I do so desperately want to find the cause, as I'm sure you do too, my friend. It breaks my heart to see puppets turned into murderous tools of bloodshed. Always welcome, friends. May I be of service?
At the House of Anini, even Price... Oh dear. This is the mark of the Black Rabbit Brotherhood, a notorious band of stalkers. The Stalkers as a unified force ceased to be after their defeat at the Battle of the Workshop Tower. The Black Rabbit Brotherhood took over the Marlam District after that. I believe you could use this mark to move safely whilst on the Black Rabbit Brotherhood's turf, to use their unsophisticated vernacular, and give you entree to the black market as well. But be careful, sir. The Black Rabbit Brotherhood is quite infamous for how they treat interlopers. If they catch you, they'll put you in the liar's coffin. Yes, I believe it is as unpleasant as it sounds. Ah, and I see we have new physical records to catalog for the collection. Such effort deserves commensurate reward, don't you think?
To me.
At the House of Anini, even.
Feel alright. Just don't spill me off through the night.
You know that Stalker? The Hound? Is it true you brought him here? Wow! I didn't know he was still alive. Thank heavens! I haven't seen him in person, and I don't know how I'd react. How do you thank the man who saved your life? I'm so glad that someone so kind has reached safety. And speaking of safety, please take care of yourself out there. You're not the only one who's curious. Most people get around to asking where I'm from. My looks give it away, don't they? Suffice it to say, I'm from the country of the morning, beyond the ocean. But I wouldn't be much of a tour guide. All I know about it is their weapons. My family was a house of weapons specialists. It's quite a reputation to live up to. They almost took charge of planning for the grand exhibition. But that's their reputation, not mine. And they deserted me when I was little. I don't even know who they are. And my reputation is my own. I suppose my only connection to them would be weapons. So, I'm an orphan, and that hardly makes me exotic and crot. Can I help you with anything else?
I feel good, cause I just know feeling of you. Give it to me, baby. Feel alright.
it's you. This hotel is indeed a refuge from the dangers of the outside world. I am the Hound, a descendant of the city's most aristocratic families. Repaying debts is what we nobles do. Anyone with a worthy spirit is especially welcome. Accordingly, I shall give you the honor of laying eyes upon my treasure. However, you must prove your worthiness. For this legendary treasure, the ergo of a powerful enemy shall suffice. It's up to you if you want to make the exchange. Take your time to admire it. I've certainly done likewise. A great weapon calls for a great warrior. Show me that you're worthy to wield it.
The cathedral. It seems nowhere is safe now. Maybe those who went there seeking refuge became monsters somehow. But the petrification disease turns you to stone. Not into a monster. I'm worried about the Malam district, just below the cathedral. I wonder whether there are monsters there, too.
Petrification disease turned into a monster. That's just tragic. Could the disease lead to puppet frenzy? No, that doesn't make sense. Remember, puppets cannot get the disease. But puppets shouldn't frenzy either. I made them to obey and protect humans, not go berserk and harm them. But the Stalkers blame me. They think I worked with the alchemists to spread the disease to puppets. How sad. All this resentment, with a lie at the root of it. That's why my only wish is that you stay a good boy. No resentment. No lies.